Hey guys, so we had day one. Hey, it's 7 a.m. Eastern my time. Today we're going to talk about Facebook. I know everybody, when they talk about Facebook, they talk about all the ads and stuff. But I'm going to tell you what, right now, guys, if you're running ads on Facebook, you have a lot of competition. Lead quality is going down and ad costs are going up. Right? It's costing you more money to generate a lead on Facebook now than ever before. But I'm going to show you something free. I'm going to show you a couple of free things here. Free and easy, right? We all like free and easy. Give me the thumbs up if you like free and easy. So guys, Facebook buy and sell groups. Facebook buy and sell groups. And what I'm telling you is not spamming the group. So a lot of agents think that, you know, Facebook marketing is they take the link from, you know, their website or landing page. They spam it all over everywhere. Guys, you don't want to do that. That's not the way to do it. So what you're looking for now, three keys. I put three keys here. Now, you can do two different things with Facebook groups, and we're going to talk about both of them real quick. Number one, you can actually go out there and you can post properties for sale on it. I will tell you, the simpler you make your ad, I see a lot of agents, they make their ad like 2 pages long. They put every single detail about the house. Guys, when you do that, if somebody isn't interested in the house, they just don't message you. They might be interested in the house. That house you got isn't for them, right? A lot of agents, the biggest problem a lot of agents have is they want to just copy and paste. They don't know how to write an ad. I'll tell you, now there's two keys to writing an ad, and we're gonna put it up here right now. You want to do, you call it the two C's. Or at least that's what I've been told it was called, the two C's, okay? You want to create, you want to create curiosity, and you want to start a conversation. That's what you want, right? Our ads, what people don't really understand, or what a lot of agents don't understand, is without the conversation, if we don't create curiosity, then we won't never start a conversation. And conversations are what lead to real estate sales. Plain and simple. That's what you're looking for. When you're on the phone prospecting, when you're calling for sale owners, you're looking for conversations. You're not looking for anything else. Your ads need to create a little bit of curiosity and create a conversation. So, therefore, let's use this as an example. 3-bedroom. Okay, now this is just an example here, but you'll get what I'm talking about. Okay, let's say we put the picture of the house. We put 3-bedroom, 2-bath home with garage in Carolina Forest. Carolina Forest is a popular area of my market. So very nice home, just remodeled for under $200,000. Now, when we write that, we want to have a house in mind. We want to have a listing in mind. We don't want it to be a general listing, but we want to make the ad a little bit more general. Okay, now here's the thing. If we put 3-bedroom, 2-bath house in Carolina Forest for $199,000. Okay, and you got somebody that maybe they can afford up to $150 or $175. Okay, they're probably not going to message you about this. Okay, if there's a lot of situations where they're just not going to message you, if you put all the details out there on the ad, then there's no reason to message you, right? People, there could be somebody that's interested in buying real estate in your market, that's interested in Carolina Forest. However, you know, you put 40 pictures up there, you put a link to the website, you put the address, you put everything. The person has no reason to contact you, right? Guys, putting an address on there, putting an address on your ad allows people to go check out the property, check it out online, Google it and all this stuff without ever saying, hey, Jason, I'm kind of interested in a house in Carolina Forest. Now, here's the thing. If you start a conversation with them, you have the opportunity to tell them a little bit about the house. Tell them it's $199. Say, hey, do you guys want to buy a house in Carolina Forest? Oh, yeah, we would have been in Carolina Forest. Well, you have the opportunity to ask more questions. You have the opportunity to ask about the price range. You have the opportunity to ask about other stuff. Maybe they don't want to be in this community, but they really want to be in the community down the street. But if they never contact you to tell you that they're interested at all, or just to inquire about it, then you never have the opportunity. You never have the opportunity of that conversation. We need to post ads that are going to create conversations, not ads that have 110% of the information. Okay? That's key number one. Pictures are great, but one or two pictures, not 10. You know, you want them to message you and say, hey, do you have any more pictures? Yeah, I do. What's your email address? I can send them over to you. You know, that way you get more contact information, right? Then you can actually put them in your CRM. You can send them properties they're actually interested in, rather than the one chance. Guys, and I feel like a lot of us are missing this as real estate agents. So now I'll tell you, so external links, if you do this and you put an external link that goes to your page, you know, ABC Realty Miami or whatever it is, .com, that external link is not going to show up in the newsfeed. It's not going to show up in a lot of news feeds. If you notice, they're not in Marketplace either. So nobody's really going to see it except for you and the people that actually visit the group to look at it. So it ends up being kind of wasted time lots of times, you know. Sometimes if people comment on it, their friends see it, but that's really it. You don't get a lot of mileage for that. That was number three. Number two, a lot of individual groups don't syndicate to marketplace. So here's the deal, guys. There's a lot of for sale by owners, and there's a lot of things being posted for sale by owner that are in these buy and sell groups that you're never going to see if you're just looking at marketplace. But if you actually go and look at these 8 or 10 groups daily, you'll actually see these for sale by owners listed. That's number two. Now, number one, we did a countdown. I did these backwards, but you know, it's okay. It's the same information and you guys are getting this, right? Leave me a comment if this makes sense to you. Yes, this makes sense, or no, it doesn't. I need more information, and I'll do another video explaining it a little more in depth for you. But number one, guys, you're not going to set a listing appointment with these for sale owners in the Facebook group through Messenger. You're just not going to do it. You know, do not have your expectation that, hey, you're going to send them a message that says, hey, my name's Jason and I sell real estate and I'm amazing and you guys should use me. I'd love to list your house. And they're going to go, yeah, please come over. Please come over. Bring all the listing paperwork with you. That's typically not how it's going to work. However, you do have the opportunity to set up a phone appointment where then you go through your script, you go through your dialogue. And guys, if my for sale by owner script is in my book, How to Be a FSBO Master, it's available on Amazon. Or if you're in my group coaching, all my scripts are in there and you get my script book for free. So, but guys, you're not going to set an appointment through the phone. So this is your easy script for sellers, right? I told you I want to give you actionable content that you can leave right now and go do it. You send them a message about their house from the for sale by owner ad, and you say, hey, what's a good number to call you for this property? That's it. I know a lot of you all want to send them a 3-page dialogue that tells about you and your company and your dog and how you're great and, you know, how your favorite color is purple. And, you know, I know you guys want to do that, and that's the tendency we have. But, guys, keep it simple. Keep it simple. What's a good number to call you for this property? They'll respond more than likely. They're going to respond with a phone number. Now, I know a lot of you are going, I need to tell them that I'm a real estate agent. First message. Guys, it's on your Facebook page, or should be on your Facebook page. If it's not, you need to put it on there. But what's a good number to call you on this property? They give you the phone number and you say, fantastic. When will you be available? They say, oh, I have a lunch break at 1. Fantastic. I'll call you at 1. You set the timer on your phone or set the timer on whatever. You call them at 1 o'clock. How hard is that? Give me a thumbs up if that sounds really easy to you. Almost sounds too easy, doesn't it? I guarantee you, though, it's going to work. Okay? Here's my script for buyers. What's a good number for you? When will you be available? You notice a pattern? This one is just as easy as the other one. Now, I'm sure that some of you guys are thinking about chat bots and all this stuff. Guys, it doesn't need to be that complicated. Remember, we talked about free, right? So what's a good number for you? They're going to give you their number more than likely. There's a good chance they'll get the buyer, give you their number. And you say, fantastic. When will you be available? They'll give you a time. You set it up in your timer. You set it up in your day planner. That's it. So guys, a lot of agents were just making this whole Facebook thing too difficult. So guys, don't forget to subscribe. We got another great tactic, another great strategy tomorrow that's going to be completely free. That is a lead source that you can go make money. I guarantee you this Facebook thing that we talked about today, you can start doing this. And guys, consistency is the key. If you do it one day and quit, it's not going to get you any results. But if you do it, if you spend 10 minutes, 15 minutes doing it today, you spend another 15 minutes tomorrow, you spend another 15 minutes the next day, you start doing it every day, Monday through Friday, while you're watching TV, it can be at 10 o'clock at night. Guys, you will get results. So don't forget to subscribe. You don't want to miss tomorrow's video. Tomorrow is a great strategy. And guys, if you want to know more, if you need scripts, if you need dialogues, you're looking for easy systems, low cost, no cost systems for your real estate business, go to Jason Morris Group Coaching. Use the code YouTube and save 50% on the first month of my group coaching. It's month to month. It's going to be 20 bucks a month. You're spending more in coffee in 2 or 3 days, I promise you. And guys, it's going to change your business. So guys, I'm going to see you tomorrow. Have a great day.